Hello, everybody. Welcome to Tentalica. A nice TV advantage, 450 up against Lizard Men. Obviously, this does mean he's only got 11 players, but he will have a Wiz and Silly Billy. But obviously, he hasn't really got the tools. He's got lots of block, actually, and a guard. It's actually pretty well built. Well, he's got too much sidestep. But it's very TV efficient, isn't it? Very TV efficient. 6-3-2, decent record. But and he will have Silly Billy and a Wizard, but obviously one would hope with 30 players, 14 players, Claw Pom, some block, some guard, best Fagor, should be good match. Yeah, he's got some great Saurus level ups. He could even go Morgan Wiz, couldn't he? If he really wanted to, he could just go Morgan Wiz. But then I might just claw pom him. I imagine Silly Billy and Wizard and then like a Babe or something. Trying to kill some Saurus Oogler. Well, even though they've got block, which is about a bastard. Ah, thank you very much, Sharnik. Thank you. And do you know what? I need to sort out the Patreon. Man, I really need to fucking sort it out. I've just been... It's so shit because when I'm playing Blood Bowl and then I'm just fucking lapsing on everything. I'm really bad. But, thank you. Well, so I guess you're VIP. VIP Sharnik. 3 minutes ago. $10. Thank you very much. Super, super VIP. Sharnik, let me do the stuff for this. Thank you very, very much. If you want a custom entrance when you come in, you can have it, such as Jam Toast landing Jam Side Down, and don't worry, Love the Cavalry's here for Senna 89. But yeah, crazy, crazy stuff. Thank you very, very much. No, he got the bribe. Fair enough. I guess he was always going to put in his own money, wasn't he? Because this kind of, like, that's when the putting in your own money is very good, because you know he's getting hammered if he doesn't. You can eat pasty, man. So. Pointless bribe. It is a pointless bribe, but yeah, better off two babes. Yeah, I agree, Carl Ancelotti, but I guess he wants to foul my claw pommer every chance he gets, doesn't he? And then he's sending out a bit of a statement with that. I guess that's what he's saying. Obviously, I just want to receive, kill as many players as I can. But if he's only got 8 players on offense, he might not score. But it does give him the max 11 to defend with, which is, you know, it could be a mistake. But then if he's attacking 11 versus 11, he might get a few removals and use the wizard to force the score. And then I draw. So I think my best chance to win is definitely to receive and just hope to get a few removals. Dirty play the fuck out of him. Claw pom the fuck out of him. And then if second half he's starting with 8 or something, then 8 versus 11 second half, hopefully, should be all right. Yeah, winning the kickoff is pretty big. Right, so yeah, I'm just going to turn it off again and not look at chat, because it does. I feel so bad at the moment, but I've just got to go. I've got to go for this, qualifying, haven't I? So I think I need another 4 or 5 wins now, but we shall find out.
Thank you.
Wow, he's taking a long time, isn't he? It's doing my head in. Well, really lucky with that double one there, but that's why I wanted to carry with Ducky Fago, because just on the off chance of the stun, isn't it, on the thing there. I guess I've got to foul him again. Obviously got a blitz here, haven't I? Now there's no other blitz to be made. Thank you for the follow, Obsidian. Well, I'll take that trade. Not bad. He's played pretty well, this guy, I think. Done some very good moves. That last turn was very difficult. Obviously, I don't want to make a dodge with the carrier. Maybe I shouldn't have picked it up with him. I should have picked up with him in the first place. That was my mistake. Then he would have been stunned, and I would have had the 2+ dodge away with Best Fag or to rely on instead of... Obviously, there's no way I can attempt a dodge with Ducky. But no matter. Get banged on. I guess he's thinking about rerolling that. It's pretty huge if he gets the crocs in. Yeah. Good reroll. Bad follow up though. Yeah, hugely bad follow up there. I mean, obviously he wasn't always going to get a cast, but that was a terrible follow up. Absolutely terrible. In fact, now I can claw palm the crocs, in fact. Oh no, I can't, I've still got block with him, but I mean, this is easy, isn't it? Block him into him. And now, because he followed, I can do this, can't I? Which I otherwise wouldn't have been able to have done. Get the 2D on him. Into death. There you go, King Tubbs. Get banged on. Just, you died. Your crocs ago died because you made a follow up you shouldn't have done. Pretty brutal. No, that ball works. Unbelievable, Jeff. I still don't have an easy thing though. Can I do a chain? I don't know. Shit. Well, there you go, all in the second half, but I mean, he's down to 10 players max. And 50-50 to get him back. Got another Clawpom blitz on the last turn, and another foul as well. I guess he's got a tiny chance of scoring. But, shit. He's played pretty well, though, to be fair. He's played pretty well. Very well, in fact. Better than his record of 6-3-2 would suggest. Maybe he just got really unlucky. Because I only had two turns to get forward, bleeding hippie. So if I blitzed him, sure, I wouldn't have had a draw. But where do I go? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, you know, there was nowhere to go. This guy would have been another dodge to go up that way, and then I'd have had to tag him. It was just horrible. There was nothing on to get forward. He's honestly played really well. Fair play to him. Get banged on. Beautiful foul. Beautiful. All right, so it's going to be tough for him, isn't it? Nine men max. Maybe eight men. And that's what I was looking for, eight men. Obviously, I would have rather been 1-0 up with him against eight men. But it's looking like it's going to be 0-0. Well, yeah, definitely 0-0. But with him, nine men max. And his apple gun. Yeah, Demastri, I mean, his defence held because his players held for it long enough, didn't they? And he did play well. But obviously, I played badly by carrying on Bestfagos to start with, because when he got that stun, if I could have recovered with Bestfagos, it would have been all right. But because I didn't, I was pretty much screwed after that, because I couldn't dodge away on a 2+. Had to try and free him up. I mean, I still wouldn't have liked dodging away on a 2+. But I would have rather dodged away on a 2+ than you know, not have the chance to. But still, got a frenzy one side, a tackle the other side. Bestfagos can 3-dice skinks, only 2 left, neither with block. Silly Billy staying out is massive. So yeah, he's only got 8 players, 5, 6 big guys, 2 little guys. So yeah, it should be okay, hopefully. I guess I want to spread these out, don't I? Isolate his bigger boys. Right. Actually, there's something to be said for just stopping him scoring at all, isn't there? While attempting to stop the score. Because if he makes it through, I mean, he's only got 2. But if he scores, then I can't win. And I've got to win, haven't I? So I don't like this setup. But I think I've got to actually set up like this. So 2 guard with a claw palm, 1 guard with a strength thorn, the frenzy. I don't like this, but I think I've got to try and... Got to stop the breakthrough, haven't I? I think that could have been a bad follow there, maybe. To the point where he does a fucking dodge with a Saurus to cover it up. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. You know, if he doesn't follow up, then I've got to knock him down to get around the back. And instead, I just can't get around the back. Oh, man. Get banged on. Now I want to fucking block with a guy just to greed it to get him into action and him into action. He's got to come back, hasn't he? One, two, three, four, five. QFI. One, two, three, four, five, six. Absolutely, could have bet your house on that being the 1-in-9 failure. Can't actually get him around now, so I guess I've got to commit both to one side. But then he's down there, isn't he? So it's not so bad. Good sidestep. So what's his play? He can stand up and he can blitz him. He can run around and blitz him. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, GFI. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, blitzes him. And he runs screen, so it seems like having a guy back here would be good, wouldn't it? If he switches up this side, at least I've got another turn to get him back and these guys back. I'm running out of time a little bit. I need to. Yeah, this thing's playing pretty well. I think that was worth the reroll. He basically had to do it to do something, but I don't know. It's a struggle because I've obviously got to win, haven't I? Stopping him isn't good enough. I've got to get the win, so I've got to put the pressure on a bit more than what I have been doing. But at the same time, got to keep the guys safe. I guess I've got to keep Bestfagor back because 3 dice with movement 7, and a 2+ dodge is just better than the frenzy. So I guess I'll move the frenzy forward to threaten, and Bestfagor's back deep. Seems like the best way to do things. You can go there to assist that block. Gotta make this now, haven't I? Could 3-2-2 to hit the ball, but I don't think it's worth it. Just tag him. Shit. Greed it. It's kind of important to deal with his garter, isn't it? Fuck, that'll freeze up him. Oh, fuck. What a fuck up. Greed for no reason. I guess he doesn't really, because he's 5 and I'm 5. That's not so bad. I guess he dodges him out. Blitzes him. Try GFI 2 down here. Alright. To be fair, after 30 games, this is probably the best opponent I've played. I mean, at least now he's reached the point where he's outmanned so much he's really running out of options, isn't he? These based guys. He only got 2 free. Skink's going to have to 1 in 9 away, or he can't really afford to block with a skink, I don't think. Well, maybe he can, but I don't think so. Don't think this is the play for him. Now maybe he's just going to mark him and then dodge away, but it's not looking good for him, is it? Maybe I ran too far back with a Nurgle Warrior. Because yeah, he's just going to run back away. Yeah, that makes sense, him running away. That does make sense. Pretty big stun though. Unbelievable. Stun and an injury. Two removals for him there. Massive swings. That doesn't matter too much. If he does that, oh my god, he's made two Saurus dodges. Made two Saurus dodges that killed me. Wow. Unbelievable. Unfucking believable. Unfucking believable that is. Let's see, he can come in here for this ball. Two fucking 3+, 2 5+ dodges he's made. That's disappointing, isn't it? If I commit, it's really hard because if I commit one way, he just goes the other, doesn't he? You could just make this one dice, though. Doesn't seem so bad. Went a bit too far back there. But didn't fall on his ass. Skull, cause it was a skull. I don't lose out that much by doing that skull. You can just potato. I mean, I guess it's hard for him to potato now, so maybe I should pressure him more. It's hard when he's made two fucking two Saurus dodges. It does make things different. Difficult. Maybe I shouldn't have made that one dice away. I could just powered him. I mean, if I'd powered him, then it gets so much better for me. killer there, having him based by him after he blocks. Still my frenzy's free. Only four turns left to turn him over. Gotta start rolling some dice. If he just failed the 5+ either time, he would have been alright.
Thank you.
Every fucking time. Well, I guess the dream is dead. After that. But I mean, what can you do? I didn't get many removals really, but broke armor, got a lot of stuns. He did very well, but it was a horrible throw-in, wasn't it? It was an absolutely horrible throw-in. double his claw. I can find it. There you go. At least on 28, which is pretty good. Thank you for the follow, Sly Animal. Yeah, it's getting there, isn't it? It's getting there. It's a pretty decent team now. But just too little too late, really. The early games set me back into that I had to do a massive win streak. How was that really bad? Look, it turned 16 because I don't know. I think it was a bad throw-in, wasn't it? It was a bad throw-in and the ball didn't have to go on the crowd, and then I would have just picked it up with strength 4, and then it would have been all right. Maybe I should have just gone for the long bomb to try and get it up there, so I just needed the pick up on the last turn, maybe. Maybe that would have been better. If I hadn't fumbled, because I had the reroll to reroll the fumble. Maybe I could have done a long pass just to punt it. Maybe that would have been a better play. I don't know. Thank you, VIP Sword of the Morning. It wasn't that unlucky. I mean, I didn't get as many removals as I would have liked, but he did play very well. And like, it's a sort of game that if you get those Kaz early, then it snowballs, doesn't it? Which is brutal. And I mean, he made 2 5-plus dodges, let us not forget, both times. Both times he had the ball exposed to a tackle or a wrestle or a, or you know, a three die, and he made a smooth 5-plus Saurus dodge to stop it. I mean, if he hadn't made that 5-plus Saurus dodge, I just 2-died him with tackle palm. I mean, brutal. Yeah, I like the frenzy. I like a frenzy claw pommer and a tackle claw pommer. So yeah, I'd go frenzy as well in a league. I do like a frenzy one in that. There are a lot of TV. 1770 because 60 of it's pretend, and I think I will get rid of the pretend money. Thank you for the follow, Ruggie82. Right, let's get rid of two pretend monies. 14 players worth it. 1770 to 1810, yeah. Kind of is, but maybe not. Maybe it'd be better to go with 13. I don't know. I like 14. I do like 14 because with double dirty player. But then I could drop 8 by dropping the second dirty player. Go down to 1730. That might be better, actually. But then his wrestle is sometimes good. Where does he go, though, Bleeding Hippie? That's the thing. These are my 8 protected players. Where does the... you know, where does he go? It's hard to get him if you want to control your TV at all. 28 wins. So 6 more wins tomorrow. 6 wins in a row tomorrow. It's possible, I guess. It's possible if I start early and get some luck. But, yeah. If I start early and play all day, 9 hours, it's doable, isn't it? And plus get early concessions. Maybe I could have bought the beast then, actually, with 210. I could have just bought the beast. I just wasted... No, I didn't. I bought him for 60. I spent 60, so I guess I could have spent... Could have had 70k in the bank and had a beast as the 14th player and then go up to 1910. Yeah, it's tough, isn't it? It's tough to fit everybody on the pitch, really, but nice to have a block club. Block Mighty Blow Claw guy to get some more. Yeah, it has been a rough day. You're quite right, Carl Ancelotti, yeah. I mean, this was a draw or a loss. And this was a draw. And this was a draw. So, yeah. Beast of Nurgle increases RNG because it just... He just rolls a fucking one. That's how I lost one of my games with my other team. Thank you very much, Skurometo. Thank you. Um, 28-3-4 beats current top Nurgle. What am I? I'm 26-0-6. So it's hard to know, isn't it? Drop Nurgle and play Brett. I drew too many early on, really. Once it was 9-5-0, it still hasn't done much better than that, was it? I've got these losses, which are a fucking pain in the ass. But I feel like I've been hard done by every time. What about 6? What about 6 losses, though? We need 6 losses now. Yeah, exactly, Carlo Ancelotti, exactly. Yeah, I'm on 6 losses, so let's see somebody with 6 losses. This one. Oh, Christ. So to get as high as him, which to be fair, he's pretty high, I would need 13 wins and I'd be as high as him. That's unlikely. Don Chump's nearly got 6 losses. Lizard men run 33 wins, 6 losses. So that'd be 7 wins. 7 wins, I'd get as high as him. Yeah. Yeah, I think Dark Elves early on. Yeah. Yeah, it did. Yeah, it did. So Skrull did. Yeah, I do like that VIP Skrull dude. Ah, well, yeah, sure, Valina. I could have had at least two more losses. I don't know about should have. I mean, he was very lucky to get in that situation. He'd survived four dice on the ball with tackle, pom on that wolf. He survived then like a further six dice on the ball, about 10 dice on the ball. I mean, it was ridiculous the luck he had with that, before he just played stupid. And, you know, the guy who conceded was only 26% to win. That's more likely would have been a loss. I don't think I've got brutally lucky in any game, really. I think I've got, you know, like, because you'd expect my claw pom to fucking smash the fuck out of people, wouldn't you? That's not unsurprising when my claw pom just tees off on people. But I'd seem to have had a lot of rough games where just key rolls of... Yeah, of course, but he was an idiot. So that's the thing, Valina. So he was an idiot. So I should have won because I just had so many dice on the ball. And he played so bad. And sure, he had really good luck. Really good luck. So he should have won. But he was incapable of it, even with the luck that he had. Yeah. 26-8-2 beats 14-2, or does it? So what's that? 26-8-2. So that's four more wins. Four or five. Four wins maybe tomorrow, something like that. Maybe seven. Yeah, the agility five. You know, he just let me hit his agility five for no reason. And do you know what? I wasn't going to pile on the flesh golem. And when he didn't stand firm, I thought I can have a free pile on. And on another day, I could have piled on and killed him, couldn't I? But instead, I piled on. Nothing happened. Had to dodge away, and it was just horrible. I don't know. I think over the course of all of the other games, I think I have had some bad luck with this team. I do think that. I mean, look at the game that I lost. You know, saying that I should have lost an extra game. When you look at one of the games that I lost, I don't think, you know, I mean, there's no arguing that it was unlucky as hell, wasn't it? This one is outrageous. 12 AV breaks, 8 Kaz, 3 KOs. I mean, that what an absolute fucking joke that game was. So, I think overall with this team, I've had some pretty bad luck, but I just didn't give myself a chance to qualify with any other team. So I think... And it was, yeah, this season was fucked by all the early Nurgle games that I kind of had to have. But,
sorry.
It's okay. But what I'm going to do in a few days' time when the ladder resets, I'm going to bust out the Dark Elves, hopefully with Fash commentating, and I'll just try hard from the start. And I'll you know, hopefully bust out to something like 20-0, something close to that. Whatever the formula says is like a decent amount of games, and then I'll just bust them all out early on in the season so that I can just stand on top of the leaderboard like Inarian did, you know. And then, even though he's fallen down, at least he's got that out in front. So yeah, I'll go Dark Elves early on. I'm not going to bash out the fucking Brits. Fuck Brits. But yeah, I think I'll go dull Dark Elves. Oh, if Chorf's gone for season 3, no chance of them coming out in a few days. But if they come out for season 4, then I will do. I don't know if Fash is going to go for a run of his own. 3 days playing Doom. Yeah, I bought Doom today. But yeah, I don't know what I'm going to do. I think I'll go for Dark Elves early. Yeah, Inarin is actually in a pretty risky situation, isn't he? Because Junicy is only one. The thing is, though, who would it be, though? And he's not that far behind, is he? When you think about it, he's not that close to getting kicked out, because he would still be he'd still be in the top two. And then there's undead, dwarves, orcs. It'd have to be this Dark Elf that would kick him out, which is 19-1-1, which is a pretty fucking good record. So I guess he's not that far away of putting him out, but yeah, Doom is good. All right, good. Yeah. Oh, the 14-0 Woodies are the ones coming up. Oh yeah, 14-0 Woodies. Yeah. But still. Yeah, so he is in a pretty tough situation, but still, it's the top of each race, and it's the top two other ones, two wild cards, which at the moment is two extra Wood Elves. So yeah, I think next time I'll start early with Dark Elves next time, and then because I'm going back to England on January the 14th, so I'm gonna hit it strong for 10 days. And then go to England, and then my undead team is out of it, mate. The top undead is 17-1-0, way better than mine. I could go undead at the start of the next season, but again, they're just, because they don't have the agility four, they're more susceptible to just getting banged on, aren't they? You know, like some lucky Kaz, and like that last turn there, having to make some 2+ and a 3+. I think you get more fucked by bad luck. I think Dark Elves let you outplay people better than any other team. And I mean, looking at the games I played, I think he was definitely the best coach that I played, that last one. I think he was definitely the best coach. And, you know, I couldn't outplay. He played really well. And I really needed to get removals to stand a chance. But if I had Dark Elves, I wouldn't have needed removals to have a chance. I would have just rolled some dice and won, probably. So I don't know, obviously double ones fuck you with elves sometimes. So it's hard to say, I don't know, but I'm going to try. 10 days with Dark Elves or something. Then away for 2 weeks. And then I might make a push in the last 2 weeks if I have to. But, right, I'm off now because I'm fucking knackered. I was really tired in that game. I always say that when I lose, but I mean, well, it was a draw, but it is hard. It is hard to play when tired. But yeah, it was a pretty bad day today, wasn't it? That was a draw or a loss. And then two draws. And then the two wins were concessions. So out of the games that were actually... Oh, and this was a win. Oh, that was a concession. That was a concession. And that was a concession. So three games won and they were all concessions today. And the three that finished were two draws and a draw or a loss. So yeah, you know, I don't know about Red Joker, you know what I mean? Obviously, my team appreciates the chance to qualify, but I don't like the asterisk next to it, and in a way I wouldn't have minded getting the lose and being able to give up, but I guess I'm going to have to, I'll carry on tomorrow and hopefully get 5 or 6 or 7 wins and see what happens. Yeah, thanks everyone, see you later.